Hey, Markieff, Mike Trudell back in LA. I wanted to ask you first just about the shooting rhythm that you've been in, especially from three. How do you think you were able to find that kind of touch, just given the, you know, the lack of total playing time going back to March? Where have you found your success from a shooting standpoint?
Just repetitions, man. Same thing over and over every day. Being out on the court a little bit more, figuring out, you know, how to play with the guys that I'm on the court with, finding my sweet spots. But shit, I shot 40% when I was in Detroit from the three, so it's really nothing new.
Hey, Markieff, it's Dave. How much do you think your development with this team in the bubble was delayed by not being here from the start? And when do you feel like you might have made up for that and hit your stride?
It definitely was a super delay. I had to stay in California and deal with a couple things. I knew eventually, you know, I would get around to catching that groove that we had before all this stuff happened. We got some time in the gym right before we came out here, so I was able to, you know, get it in with them. But it just was a different dynamic. You know, we didn't have Rondo also, so, you know, we had to play a little different brand of basketball. But, you know, we back to regular schedule program, and the game is a lot easier for us when we play the right way.
Allison.
Denver plays so different from Houston, and there's a lot more moving. There's a lot of screens. Obviously, they have a lot more size. How hard is just that first game of, like, getting used to how much they move, how much they cut, how much they screen?
We got a chance to play them a couple games before the playoffs. I would think the last game or the last two games, one of those. So we got a feel for how much they move. But we're a veteran team, and we locked into all that. You know, it's the playoffs. We got to be locked into all that. We got a lot of guys that, you know, that's been here before. We're 12 deep. So, you know, if a guy not on his job, we send somebody else in that's paying attention to detail more. So, you know, with us, it's just the fact that, you know, we got a lot of veteran guys, and, you know, we could keep sending players in and out at you.
Good. Will, do you have anybody back on your end?
I can take a couple more.
Please do, that'd be great.
All right, Al.
Hey, Markieff, just to get your thoughts, obviously a great win yesterday, and you mentioned a veteran team. Denver's found a way in two straight series to come back. How much is that conversation about, you know, keeping your foot on the gas, making sure you take your opponent, respect the opponent that you have? How much of those conversations are being had after game one?
Oh, a lot. After watching them be two great teams back-to-back, after being down 3-1, they're the comeback kids. You know, that's what we're going to keep going by. They like to come back. So we know we ain't had a best shot yet. We know they've been down 3-1 and it's still early. But, you know, like I said before, we're a veteran team, and we got a goal in mind. We're going to, you know, keep pressing forward to our goal.
All right, last two from me. Melissa?
Hey, Markieff, when you first joined the Lakers, I'm curious, was there one player in particular who you sort of leaned on who made the transition a bit easier?
Oh, for sure. JD. It's my third team with him on there. He made it easier for me when I was in Phoenix. He made it easy for me when I was in Washington. You know, man, you know, I know the perception of me and my brother in this league and what people see on TV. So they might, you know, judge early on, but it's just basketball, you know what I mean? So it was easy for me to get acquainted with these guys, having JD around, letting them know that, you know, we're great guys, and, you know, all that stuff that follows around is not true.
All right, last one here, Christos.
Hello, Markieff.
You.
Do you believe that the game one against Denver will gonna set the tone for the whole series?
It's going to set the tone for us for sure. We're not letting up. We're going to play hard. We're going to play together. We're going to be aggressive the whole series. But you have to respect them. You know, they're in the Western Conference Finals for a reason. We don't think that, you know, it's ever going to be easy. We don't hope that it's easy. We want to go out there and compete at the highest level, play our brand of basketball every night.
All